So I've been getting lots of requests about how to use dilators to overcome vaginismus. So I have a little set of, they're a little bit like Russian dolls, these dilators. These I bought back in 2013 after a perineal repair surgery. That's quite a, let's say, quite a large starter. It is possible to get a range of dilators with a much more varied size scale, basically, so that you don't have to start with something that is this big. But I'm going to go through some of the things that you can do to help you to be able to actually relax in order to use the dilators and to have a successful opening, shall we say. So the first thing that I want to say is that when I get questions, very often it's around stretching of the vagina. Now, I know that that's often how dilators are pitched and that's often how it is explained to people. But in reality, you're not actually trying to stretch the vagina. What you're trying to do is to communicate safety to your nervous system so that the protective tone, which is what vaginismus is, it's where your nervous system is basically contracting the muscles, and you want to get a safety message to the nervous system so that it will let go instead of holding on to tension. And once there is a let go, then it is possible to achieve penetration. So what we will do, I'm just going to lay back here on the bed. So one of the first things is the position that you will take. So you can just lie like this. Now, when you lie like this, you can see that my knees are quite close to the sides of the bed. The adductor muscles on the insides of the legs connect through connective tissue directly into the pelvic floor. Now, if the legs, when you come into this position, don't actually relax so that these muscles can let go of the tension that holds your legs up, then it is much more difficult to allow the pelvic floor to relax. So if you want to give yourself a little bit of extra support, you can take two pillows and you can put them either side, and then you can really allow the legs to relax. Now you can see here that I don't need to use any effort at all to hold my legs here. But I'm a little bit low down, so if I want to, I can actually put some more pillows behind my back. So you can set it up whatever way you need to so that you can be a little bit more upright. Now in this position, I can allow everything to relax. And then with the smallest dilator, you can start. But before you start, these muscles are the ones that close your legs, basically, the adductor muscles. And they are like a protective muscle. So along with the pelvic floor, if the nervous system doesn't feel safe, they're going to want to do this. So they're going to want to close the space. Don't let anything in. And of course, if you're trying to overcome vaginismus, you want to be able to relax and to open like a flower rather than closing everything up. So you need to get these muscles to relax. So start with a little bit of massage just to let them go, and then you want to also try to get everything to relax by bringing a state of calm, and then if needed, a state of arousal. Now you can very gently just rub the fingers on the insides of the legs. If needed, if you're with a partner and you're trying for penetration, start with clitoral stimulation. Don't go straight for penetration. The key to turning on the relaxation, the lubrication and the opening of the vagina is to turn the on switch, which is the clitoris on the outside. So you don't want to, if you are trying to penetrate, you don't just want to go straight in. You should always turn the on switch on so that everything relaxes and opens and lubricates. So get everything to relax, get yourself to relax, and then you can take your dilator and then you can start with very slow and very gentle insertion and taking it out. Now, I have heard people say that you should put the dilator all the way in and leave it in there for 10 or 15 minutes. That is not really ideal. So what you want to do as much as possible is to mimic penetration. So you want to put the dilator in and out. So you want to actually allow the muscles to feel the dilator going in and coming out, going in and coming out, rather than just putting it in there and leaving it in there. I mean, it's not actually not normal to put something in and leave it in unless it's a tampon, in which case that's going past the muscles and the muscles are helping for it to stay up in there. So practice in the same way as you would actually go through the act when you are trying to eventually achieve penetration. Take your time, be as relaxed as possible, and remember that if you do want to try penetration, make sure that you're with somebody who makes you feel safe. Make sure that you feel that you're in the headspace for going there. If there's a lot of fear, fear communicates to the nervous system. So your nervous system cannot tell the difference between what you're thinking and reality. So if you are afraid, your nervous system will sense that. So as much as possible, try to relax, try to find your happy place, and try to let go of tension. The pillows will help. If you don't have to hold your legs up, the pillows will help. You can also take side-lying positions if that's easier for you. But I do suggest pillows to the side, lots of pillows behind you so that you're propped up, and then a lot of relaxation. If you don't produce enough natural lubrication, you can also use other types of lubrication. Personally, I opt for cold-pressed organic coconut oil. It's the stuff that you use to cook, and I use that because your skin, it's permeable, so it absorbs whatever you put on it. So if you're not going to eat it, maybe you shouldn't put it on your skin. That's at least the way I look at it. So I hope this was helpful. If